Resolution Sports. MB. What up, Roomie? I told you I got you. Resolution Sports, the number one source. Breaking from football up to extreme sports. So come on and join the resolution. Join the resolution. So come on and join the resolution. Join the resolution. Resolution Sports, the number one source. Breaking from football up to extreme sports. So come on and join the resolution. Join the resolution. So come on and join the resolution. Join the resolution.
Basketball, soccer, MMA, boxing, any other sport you like. This is the website.
And here we go once again. We are back out here in Homedale, New Jersey, rolling right into episode 3, Chasing Goals with Rachel Breton. Rachel, talk to us a little bit. How you feeling? Been a little bit since we spoken last, but let's catch everybody up on what's happened over the past couple weeks.
I'm feeling good. I'm feeling great. I mean, it's a sauna over here on the surf. It's great. Thanks so much. Thank you, Don Vianney. And the past couple of weeks, we're on a losing streak for the Wildcats a little bit. It's in a little slump, but it's all right. We played really well last week with the Valkyries on Wednesday. And we played Washington Reserve team. That was tough.
But talk to that a little bit, Rachel. That's not something that generally you've been experiencing here. It's a team that doesn't even suffer many losses in a season. But for any of those people out there, how do you kind of get yourself through that? Keep grinding through and, keep just focusing on the job at hand.
Yeah, well, this year is a development year for the Wildcats. We only had two returning, Jesse Cello and myself, and Catch Puka. And other than that, it's a lot of young kids. Late high school to early freshman year of college, so it's a transition for everyone. But it's good though. It's not like we're playing bad. It's pretty good. But prepping for it, it's just you get to learn each other's abilities and you get to see like what's going on in the game if it's an individual or the team in a whole or whatnot.
Absolutely, and definitely developing something great for the future. But if you will, Rachel, why don't you break down just a little bit, what's going on here in this cup here?
Let's go. Okay, so, I don't know if it's good, but it's a muscle recovery tea, and I put some ginseng in it, and it makes my muscles and I feel good. I do it 2 days all the time, so I gotta recover somehow besides hydrating, and gotta feel energized and ready to go, game after this.
So you're telling me that training 487 times a week and playing 76 games a week, you need some type of muscle recovery for that?
Something like that. You gotta make sure that you're hydrated. You gotta do your get your 30 after 30 minutes, get your meal in, get some protein in. I go to Smoothie King, get some smoothies.
I hear you. Nothing smoother than Smoothie King.
Nothing smoother than smoothies.
Well, all right, Rachel, we're about closing here on kickoff here with the Wildcats. But once again, we're going to be stalking you all day long, so we'll make sure to keep the people updated on what's happening. But stay cool out here, stay hydrated, and, go handle your business.
Thanks.
All right, thanks, Rachel. And we're back. Once again, Piscataway, New Jersey is our new location. Just wrapped up in Homedale, New Jersey. For those of you who are not from New Jersey, those are two places in New Jersey. It's all you need to know. Mm-hmm. But the Wildcats got back to the winning ways. Rachel, 3-1 victory over the New York Magic. Hard-fought victory. But give me your thoughts and reactions from that game.
We broke the seal of the losing streak. It's great. It's well-needed. We played well. Held it down. We talked about getting the goals early in the first half so we can kind of close down and just play after that, and that's exactly what we did. They got a goal at the second half, but that's all right. We still got a 3-1 victory, and hopefully now we just keep going up. No ups and downs, just up.
Absolutely. And how important do you think it is to jump out to that lead like that? To have that, a lot of soccer to be played, but to have a 3-goal cushion, you have to feel a little bit more comfortable.
Well, it's really important to have that because, you want to be in control of the game. You don't want to play a really good game like we did last time and then the last 2 minutes get a bad goal scored on us and then oh no, we should finish our opportunities. You have to finish up every opportunity that you get.
And then there were some scares there in the second half, but, you know, a few balls bounced in the right direction for once.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, but collectively, you know, after that game was concluded, to have won the game, you know, and gotten rid of that losing streak, you know, be back on the right path, you know, how does the team feel, you know, kind of going forward from here?
It was good. You know, there were some smiles at the end of the game, and I think everyone put in a good effort. Everyone worked hard and, you know, just constantly improving. As I said before, we're developing. Developed well today.
There was some development today. I saw it.
Just a little bit.
But now here we are in Piscataway, your sack field on the campus of Rutgers University. Sky Blue FC about to play the Portland Thorns for sole possession of first place. Both teams knotted up, 8-2-1. But give us your thoughts going into this game, and keep in mind that we're going to get your post-game thoughts too, so you best watch what you say.
I'm not going to have any predictions because I don't like jinxing things, but, you know, we're a great team, and playing with this team, it's just great, and everyone plays so well, and we just really understand the game, and our coaches are really great also. I keep saying great, but it's very true, and we just have to play our game. If we play our game, I think we're fine, and I think that, you know, that it's going to be fun. It's going to be fun, you know. They're going to...
Absolutely. And this is, you know, in the short history of the National Women's Soccer League, have to be said that this is the biggest game, you know, in its short history with both of these teams, you know, playing so well. But, you know, what kind of representation do you think this gives? You know, obviously the fans are pouring in. It's going to be a big crowd today. But what type of representation do you think this has, not only for the league, but also for the future of the league?
I think it's going to be, it's going to be good. You know, everyone's already lined up watching the warm-up, and I know that some of my friends are coming. I know a lot of people are coming. We pull out tickets down, and it makes a really good environment because it makes people want to keep coming. You know, the atmosphere is so key because it just shows that this league is not going away, and women's soccer is not going down, but it's going up.
No doubt about it. All right, Rachel, we'll let you finish up the pregame prep, but like I said earlier, we will be catching back up with you. The world tour continues. We're in New Jersey. Back at it. Ripping shades off. That's what we do around here.
Rip them on.
Putting them on.
I gotta go.
Exactly. And that's how we do. We're out. Here we are one more time. Don't know who we're talking to by now. You have been watching. Rachel Breton. Still here. Still in Piscataway. Still screaming, adoring fans behind us. But Rachel, another one in the books here today. Both teams fought hard. End result was a 0-0 stalemate. But talk us through the game a little bit and what you saw out there.
It was great. Portland played well. We played very well. The last 15 minutes, man, we held it down. We held it down. I love that we just kept going. Just kept going, kept pressing, kept combining. There was a lot of tag in the final third and a lot of shots. You know, it was just a great experience for, you know, soccer. It was a great game to watch, too. All the fans seemed pretty excited. I was even, like, freaking out. Yeah. Crazy person.
Absolutely. What's it say about the fitness of the team, you know, to really find, you know, that extra few gears? You know, like you said, the last 15 minutes with them, especially there, you know, in the 90th minute and into stoppage time.
Yeah.
I think there was probably four or five opportunities that almost were, you know, finished off. But what's it say about the fitness of this team?
Yeah, well, it's great. And we do a lot of ball work, you know, a lot of things, a lot of fitness with the ball. And we get this, you know, game prepared and game shape. So, you know, it comes out. It, you know, you see it in the game. You see that we're, you know, last 15 or so minutes, you know, it's you hold it down.
No doubt. And now the team is officially in the second half of the season, now officially 12 games in, 10 to go. You know, to be at this point in the season, you know, the team right now, 8-2-2. But what's your overall, you know, opinion and, you know, take on, you know, how the team has looked so far? And how do you think the, you know, the last 10 games of the season, how strong do you think the team will finish?
I think we're really, really strong. I think we're just, you know, great. Overall, like, very tactical. You know, it's... our fitness level, our ball work, the way we play, everything is just fantastic, and it's really fun. It just makes it, it's the best part about it, like, it brings out the love of the sport and the funness of, if that's even a word, the funness.
We'll make it one.
Hashtag.
But, yeah, definitely, it's you know, the fun is definitely being displayed on the field, and you can see that this team really gets along and enjoys playing with each other. But back to what's going on with you, Rachel. Another game, another two games in the books today alone. But, you know, let everybody know, you know, kind of what's coming up for you this week. You know, Sky Blue's back in action. Wildcats can be back in action. But, you know, give everybody a little bit of a brief verbal preview of what's going to be going on with you this week.
Preview, we go tomorrow off a little recovery. Monday, back at it. Tuesday, back at it. And then a game against Kansas City on Wednesday. Thursday, Friday, and then game on Saturday.
There you go. Small work.
Just some, you know, a lot of it. A lot of soccer.
Absolutely. But we'll go ahead and close out this third episode here because you probably need to get to resting and getting ready for the fourth episode. Not mention all the training and games and, you know, those things. But most importantly, you know, this documentary we're doing. So,
yeah,
you know,
just.
But anyways, Rachel, as always, thank you for sharing some time with us.
And as always, Res Sports.
That's what I'm talking about. Those guys are great over there.
They're great. They're really good.
They're amazing.
They're amazing.
Exactly. All right, Rachel, we'll check out, and we'll be checking back in soon.
Just can't get it done. Worldwide, international. And when I need to get my message across, I'm going to Resolution Sports. That's right, the biggest and baddest of publicity. If you got a problem, well, hey, here your resolution. Go ahead and check them out on ResSports.com. And you know, while your big deals with big matters, well, it looks like you've now got somebody on your team. You gotta do a New Year's resolution! Get that camera off.